1976 so far has been a banner year with pricing games, with so many of the all-time greats debuting during this era. And for those of you who love train wrecks, have no fear because 1978 is just around the corner. So let's close out the year with a game that is still beloved by audiences today and is indeed one of the most fun games to watch, play, and cheer for. Let's jump into one of the most popular games in Price is Right history. Here we go with 5 fun facts about Switcheroo. Number 5. The game once got stuck on the turntable. Oops! In 1978, one time the game got stuck trying to spin on the turntable. It was quickly fixed, but it just goes to show the magic of television when it's live, or taped as live. While Price is Right can be edited if necessary, stopping tape only happens if it is absolutely going to grossly affect the outcome of the show. Little moments of imperfection like these never get cut out and are truly what make the show magical. Number 4. Similarities to another game. Remember during the race game when I mentioned that there was a similar game? We got there! Switcheroo shares a great deal of similarities to race game, including the timed gameplay, matching numbers to the correct prizes, and the fact that the contestant doesn't have to win every prize. In another odd coincidence, as of the recording of this video, neither game has been modernized and still rely on the classic display technology. Number 3. Big Bucks Bonanzas. Let's be real, winning a nice new car is huge. But Switcheroo has had two occasions where the contestant could have walked away with major winnings. In 2008, Switcheroo was the million-dollar spectacular game where the contestant would win the million if they played it perfectly in the first round. Then in 2014, a Maserati Quadruport SQ4 worth $109,430 was offered. Neither contestant was successful, but the thought of such big giveaways is pretty cool. Number 2. The game has never been played perfectly in the Drew Carey era. According to my research, Switcheroo has only been played perfectly 9 times in history, with the last time occurring in April of 2007, shortly before the retirement of Bob Barker. Thus, in the 15 years since Drew took over the show, Switcheroo has never been played perfectly. Obviously, this is sheer coincidence, but I'm sure it will give the Drew haters more fuel to add to their fire. And just to show how rare perfect playings are, the first perfect playing didn't occur for 9 years after the game debuted. Oddly enough, it didn't even happen on the daytime version. It happened on the nighttime version with Tom Kennedy hosting. 5 guesses, 5 right numbers, 1 very happy contestant. And the number 1 fun fact about Switcheroo: 2 special accommodations. Switcheroo might be known for having 2 of the most awesome contestant accommodations in the history of the show, and they happened within a month of each other. In October of 2003, a handicapped contestant played with the help of one of the models, and the time limit was extended to 45 seconds. 1 month later, a 99-year-old contestant played, and Bob, who as of the recording of this video is also 99 years old, explained that the clock was, in quotes, broken. While special treatment isn't always necessary, to give people with such disadvantages the same opportunities as others is so good to see.